Hi everyone, today we're going to take a look at a 10,000 milliamp hour power bank from CDRKING. This is a brand new model and it's one of the slim types. You can see it looks really nice. It's kind of a faux leather look, but it's actually all plastic. There's no metal and there's no leather. It just looks like it, but it looks really nice. Now it uses a different type of battery, which means it's very slim. If you compare that to this one from Asus, which is also a 10,000 milliamp hour battery, you can see this is much thicker in comparison. But of course the CDRKING one is much longer. So you're basically trading length for width. I like this one because it fits in your jeans pocket quite nicely since it's so slim, even if it is kind of tall. Now we'll take a quick look at the box, and I know what you're thinking, why would we want to look at a box? That's boring. We know it's a 10,000 milliamp hour battery and it's got two USB ports, so nothing else to know, right? But no, there's something special about this power bank. You'll see here that it says QuickCharge 2.0. Now that is Qualcomm QuickCharge 2.0. They don't actually use the word Qualcomm because they're not using a certified chip. It's probably like some generic that manages to clone itself as Qualcomm. But it actually does support QuickCharge 2.0. And unlike some power banks which have QuickCharge on the output but not on the input, this supports it on both the input and the output. So you can charge this thing super fast, plus you can take power out super fast. So let's take a look at these ratings on the box. 5 volt 2 amp input. Now that's pretty good because some power banks only do 5 volt 1 amp, so 2 amp is much better. But this is where it gets interesting. 9 volt 1.5 amp. That's Qualcomm Quick Charge. It uses a higher voltage to charge it faster, so you can push in more power faster. Then on the output, you can do 5 volt 2.1 amp, which is standard, or if you've got a Quick Charge device, you can charge it at 9 volts 1.67 amp. So it's not actually the exact Qualcomm Quick Charge 2.0 ratings, because they should actually be a bit higher than that, but it's still better than normal USB. So you can see with a normal charger, it says charging time 10 to 12 hours. Now I assume that's based on a 1 amp input, but if you use the Quick Charge 2.0, it can charge it in just 6 to 7 hours. So that means you can actually charge this thing and go out and start using it much faster. Now a quick word of warning, if you want to charge this using Quick Charge, you need a charger that supports that. For instance, I had this one here, which is Anchor Quick Charge 2.0 and 3.0, and then I have this multi-port charger from Orki, which has 4 regular charge ports and then 1 Quick Charge 2.0 port. So you do need a special charger if you want to charge this thing super fast. So let's put this thing to the test and see if it really can fast charge. I'm going to start by plugging my watt meter into the fast charge port of my Orki charger, and then I'll use the supplied cable to plug into the power bank. And you can see they actually give a pretty long cable. On their other power banks, they give you a short white cable, but they've actually sprung and gave us a pretty decent cable on this one. So now I've got my USB watt meter plugged into the charger, and I'm going to plug the power bank into the watt meter, and we'll see what we manage to get into this. Let me zoom in on the watt meter so we can see what's going on. Now, one thing I actually want to show you here on the power bank first is that there are 4 LEDs. The first 3 are the capacity, how much is left in the battery, and the last one only turns on, and it turns on green, if you're using a quick charge. If you're not using quick charge, that light won't light up and you'll only ever see these first 3 LEDs. So let's zoom in on the watt meter and see what we're getting. So you can see we're just under 9 volts, 1.56 amp, and we're pushing in 14 watts. So that's going to charge this thing pretty quick. Now, to be fair, that is not full speed Qualcomm, because you should be able to get up to 18 watts if this was a full Qualcomm 2.0. But I'm still happy with, you know, 14 and a half watts. That's still faster than regular charging. So let's swap this from the quick charge port to a regular USB port to see what you would get if you didn't have a special charger. And I'll zoom in on the watt meter, so you can see we're around 5 volts, 1.85 amp, and we're pushing in around 9.5 watts. So that's still plenty fast enough, even if you're just using a regular charger. But of course, the quick charge will be faster. And if we now try it with the Anchor quick charger, and I'll zoom in on the screen, you can see just under 9 volts, 1.56 amp, 14 watts, are pretty much identical. And that's what you expect when it comes to quick charge, because it is meant to be a very specific charging protocol. And again, you can see that the green light did come on to signify it's quick charging. So now I'm going to open this thing up and show you what it looks like on the inside and how they've managed to make this so slim. So inside a regular generic power bank, you'll find these 18650 lithium ion batteries. Now they look a bit like AA batteries, but they're a bit larger and they're a different chemistry. And then you have the charge board here. Now on the CDRKING battery, you'll find lithium polymer batteries. These are very similar to what you'd find inside your cell phone. There are three of them stacked on top of each other, and the charge board is here. And I'll bring that closer to the camera so you can have a look. Now the batteries basically determine the size of the overall pack. That's why this one is able to be much slimmer than this one, because these batteries are quite fat, whereas these are obviously very slim, these batteries. So let's now do a test to see if this really is 10,000 milliamp hour. Now this is a generic brand that I bought from somewhere else, and this was sold to me as a 30,000 milliamp hour. And when I did this test, it works out this is just 6,600 milliamp hour. So let's hope the CDRKING one does much better in this test. Now that rating of 10,000 milliamp hour is at the battery voltage of 3.7 volts. So if we convert that to watt hours, it works out to 37 watt hours. So when we run our test, we're looking to get 37 or higher. And to test the capacity, we're going to use this USB watt meter. I can plug one end into the power bank, and in the other end I have a dummy load. Now I set this to 1 amp, so it simulates charging a cell phone, and we'll measure exactly how much we get out of this. So the power bank has stopped outputting power. Let's take a look at the monitor and see how much power we actually got out of it. I'll just unplug it from the power bank and then I'll bring it up to the camera. So you can see it ran for around 7.5 hours, and we pulled out 33.75 watt hours. Now that works out to around 9,120 milliamp hour. So that means we're about less than 10% off our rated output of 10,000 milliamp hour. Now that's pretty incredible. And I would say that this is a true 10,000 milliamp hour battery. A small 9 or 10% loss is just going from 3.7 volts or whatever the voltage may be. It does fluctuate a little bit, going up to 5 volts. So I'm actually absolutely amazed by those results. This is a genuine 10,000 milliamp hour power bank. So that pretty much sums up the CDRKING Quick Charge 10,000 milliamp hour power bank. It is pretty much exactly what it says on the box. It's a genuine 10,000 milliamp hour battery. It does support quick charge going in and coming out. And you know, it works. It does exactly what it says on the box. I think this is the best value power bank that's currently available, because at 999 peso, you won't find another power bank that is a genuine 10,000 milliamp hour and has quick charge 2.0. So if you're looking for a new power bank, I would go to CDRKING and pick this one up, because honestly, this is probably one of the best products I've ever bought from CDRKING. So if you enjoyed this video, please give a thumbs up and subscribe. Thanks for watching.